I'm Ross Gay, and this is a poem called Weeping. I'm thinking here of the Proto-Indo-European root, which means the precise sound of a flower bud unwrapping, and the tiny racket a seed makes cracking open in the dark, which has evolved in a handful of Latinate languages to mean the sound of lovers exiting each other, implying as well the space between them, which usage is seen first in Dante in the 14th century, elbowing it for good into our mouths and minds, and of course the sweet bead of sugar imperceptibly moseying from the fig's tiny eye, precisely unlike sorrow, which the assembly of insects sipping there will tell you when I tell you my niece, without fit or wail, knowing her friend Emma had left and not said goodbye, having spent the better part of the day resting on her finger, sometimes opening her wings, which were lustrous brown with gold spots, to steady herself at the child-made gale, or when she was tossed into the air while my niece took her turn at pick-up sticks until calling Emma by holding her finger into the air, to which Emma would wobble down. And Michaela said, "Deal us in," when we broke out the dominoes, at which they made a formidable duo, whispering to each other instructions. And while the adults babbled our various dooms, Michaela and Emma went into the bedroom where they sang and danced. And I think I heard Michaela reading Emma her favorite book, both of them slapping their thighs, leaning into each other. And at bedtime, Michaela put on her PJs carefully. First, the left arm through, while Emma teetered on the right, then the other. And in the dark, Michaela whispered to Emma, who had threaded her many legs into the band of Michaela's sleeve, while she drifted, watching Emma's wings slowly open and close. And Emma must have flown away for good, judging from the not brutal silence at breakfast, as Michaela chewed the waffle goofily with her one front tooth gone, and weakly smiled, looking into the corners of the room for her friend, for Emma, who had left without saying goodbye, the tears easily rolling from her eyes when I say she was weeping, when I say she wept.